Yes, and yes, this is real carbon fiber. And this is a carbon fiber fox, and this is a carbon fiber Doberman. Check out this shine. So I had this old Lenovo netbook that was broken, had a broken screen, a broken lid, and I wanted to throw it away. But then I decided to experiment a little with it and maybe fix it. Initially I wrap it in gold carbon fiber vinyl, but then I remember that I already did one laptop like this. Besides, I don't like that I can still see the indent of the Lenovo logo. And also this top cover was broken at the hinges and the vinyl was not strong enough to keep it in place, even if I super glue the plastic with super glue. This other side is breaking as well. As you can see, there's a blob of super glue, but the other side is completely broken. Check this out. Actually, one of the nut inserts was completely missing, along with the plastic standoff. So here I already started working on fixing it, and I super glued a nut insert with some plastic in the correct spot. This is a nut insert from another hinge that I had laying around. This took some time to align correctly, so I did not film that part. You can see that the vinyl is still in place and I have to remove it carefully before beginning the next step. This was left intentionally on place and in no way because I forgot. No, no way. So I will use something way stronger than the super glue to repair this laptop, and that is epoxy resin. Here I'm mixing a way too large batch of this resin and hardener since I don't know what I'm doing. Also, this is the first time I'm working with resin, so if you take this video as a tutorial, it's your fault, and I don't want to see you complaining at the end. Because both the resin and the hardener are clear, I cannot tell if they are mixed properly, so I'm putting the resin mix in another cup, making sure not to scrape the walls of the first cup. Also, this is my first time working with, drum roll, carbon fiber. And this is real carbon fiber, which I'm handling way too rough, to be honest. What I will do is to cut some of these unusable edges and I will use them. These fibers are very thin and they can be easily breathed in your lungs. You can actually see them flying up, so always wear a mask and social distance yourself from them. Okay, now I will put some resin in the area that I need to repair, and then I will take a toothpick and pick up some fibers and then soak them really well in the resin. What I'm doing now is basically rebuilding out of carbon fiber the missing plastic piece around the nut insert. This way it will not just be resin holding the plastic, but actual carbon fiber, which is many, many times stronger. Now you would probably ask yourself, why would you try to fix a laptop that it's not worth anything with carbon fiber? At which I reply, because I can. Also, I already had this carbon fiber and resin. It's not like I bought them especially to do this. Of course not. Of course not. And you know what? Actually, I'm not receiving any more questions today, okay?
Hey, can you deal with that?
So after I use all the carbon fiber to fill up the void, I'm taking a napkin to absorb as much as I can from the resin, and also I'm pressing down the fibers to compact them. This way, I will make sure the repair is strong. It's looking quite okay in my opinion. Now I will let it cure overnight. At this point the repair could be considered done, but since I have all that carbon fiber, I decided to wrap the laptop lid with it, stepping up my game from the carbon fiber vinyl to the real thing. So what I did, I made a lot of deep grooves in the plastic cover with the 80 grit sandpaper and attached a cup underneath as a stand to keep it elevated. Also, so I can handle it without touching the surface. Now I will mix another resin batch, again way too much than needed, and this time with a black dye in order to stop the gray showing off between the fibers of the carbon, especially the chrome Lenovo logo. And now I'm spreading everywhere, and now I'm spreading it everywhere and let it become tacky to the touch. Now I'll cut a piece of carbon fiber and check those gloves. So I cut a piece of carbon fiber and I will wrap it around the edges and tape it underneath. Now what I didn't realize, this is quite a complex shape to skin for a beginner, and at the bottom of the lid I had problems with the material not sticking down and lifting up due to the bend radius. When I will do this next time, I will not stick it underneath for such steep angles. Now I'm mixing another batch of way too much resin, and I will completely soak the carbon fiber. At some point I got frustrated because the cloth was not sticking and I decided to use my fingers. This was a bad idea since in the lower left part the fibers got deformed and actually didn't help. And you can see this in the final product. Also, this lid is so wavy to begin with. This is after the resin dried up. As you can see, it looks different at the hinges part. That's because I cut that and just stick with super glue a carbon fiber rectangle on each side. I don't know, I kinda like this textured look, but I think I'll go ahead and put one more layer of resin. The edges look fine. I just cut them with a sharp box cutter blade when the material was not fully cured. Make sure you have more of those on hand. It got dull really fast. This carbon fiber is tough. Also, this is a very tough piece now. You can actually feel it much stiffer. I really like this rough look to the touch, but like I said, I will add one more layer of resin. It cannot be a bad idea. Well, this was a bad idea. I mean, it's very glossy and has depth to it, but I don't really like it. It's way too wavy, and at the top edge you can see some ripples. I think that what I will do is to sand it and just apply some lacquer. I will think about that. In the meantime, I will do these end caps of the hinges. They're supposed to be silver, but all the color went away. I will cut some carbon fiber circles from this already cured piece of carbon fiber and glue them with some super glue. And then I will mix some resin and just soak them. And this is the result. It's good, but not perfect. Good enough to not redo them again. A little now on the specs of this laptop. It has 512 megabytes of RAM soldered on the motherboard, and I will add another stick of 2 gigs that I just have laying around. The hard drive was this 80 gigabytes one, and I will replace it with an SSD. This is actually the first SSD I bought in my life back in 2013. And we will close the back. And it's working. Windows XP, baby. I tried firstly Windows 10, but was way too slow for this machine. Oh, and also, I did not tell you, but the original screen of the laptop was broken and I had to buy a new one. I also put some feet on the back because they were missing. And check this out. This is how the front looks like now. What I did was to actually sand the cover back to the carbon fiber and then sprayed some automotive lacquer on it. Here where the carbon fiber Doberman head is, was actually a bubble in the carbon fiber, and when I was sanding it, it completely shattered. So I've created these figurines to cover the defects. And here is a jumping fox. This fox is not covering any defects, but I think they look really cool and they don't stand out too much, you know, being carbon fiber as well. By the way, that sanding took more than 2 hours, and I also sanded my skin away from one of my fingers. But man, look how good it looks like, and it's so smooth to the touch. This has now only one layer of lacquer, but still looks great. The only thing is that I can see the sanding marks when the light hits the cover in a certain angle. This area at the hinges looks so good now, and you cannot tell that it's made from two pieces of carbon fiber. Let me show it to you in the light so you can see what I'm talking about. So here you can see what I'm talking about when I say the sanding scratch marks. What I need to do is to sand this with progressively smoother sandpaper, maybe all the way up to 1000 or 2000 actually, and then to apply the lacquer. But for now my hands are too tired, and I think I'll just leave it like this. And here at the bottom left you can see how the fibers are disturbed. Maybe I'll cut another animal carbon fiber shape to cover it, or maybe I will just leave it like this to remind me of my mistake. And check this out, in the sun it looks amazing, even with the scratches. I guess I could sand the scratches away, but I told you, my fingers are killing me now. Anyway, let me show you more detail. Remember, this is only after one coat of lacquer. So let me know what you think. I think my experiment was a success, especially since the notebook is now fully functional and not somewhere in the field around the neck of some poor bird. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe since I will make more videos of me working with carbon fiber. Stay safe, stay inside, and remember to be kind. Bye!